I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord.
Let us go into the house of the Lord.
And make a joyful noise unto the Lord.
Make a joyful noise unto the Lord.
All ye lands.
All ye lands.
Serve the Lord with gladness.
Serve the Lord with gladness.
Come before his presence.
Come before his presence.
With singing.
With singing.
Baby. No, you continue standing for the prayer.
Amen. Amen.
Everybody here today, most heavenly gracious Father, we're thankful for another blessed day. Yes. You allow us to come out to your place of worship one more time, Heavenly Father.
Yes.
Through your grace and mercy, Heavenly Father, you build us up and strengthen us, Heavenly Father. You show us the way, Heavenly Father.
Yes,
the right path that we must travel, Heavenly Father, get to our destination, Heavenly Father. And our destination will be with you in heaven, Heavenly Father. Yes. We're thankful for all things that have done thus far, Heavenly Father. We're thankful for your word, Heavenly Father, that's about to come out and strengthen us, Heavenly Father. Build us up and help us get through another week, Lord.
Yes.
We ask you right now to touch those that are sick and shut in, Heavenly Father. Strengthen them, Heavenly Father.
Yes.
Those who have mind to want to make it out to the service, Heavenly Father.
Yes.
And
yes.
Cannot make it, Heavenly Father. We just have to touch them. And those that are here, right now, Lord, strengthen them, Heavenly Father. Build them up, Lord. Give them a blessing upon blessing them. Fill up their cup, overflow with everlasting love, Heavenly Father. As we go through this day, each and every day, we'll actually touch our bishop, Heavenly Father. Strengthen the people, Lord. So he may be delivered more than they may strengthen each and every one of us, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' name I pray today. Amen.
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 And today's scripture is coming from 1 Peter, the first chapter, the 13th to the 16th verse, and this is the New International Version. Therefore, with minds that are alert and fully sober, set your hope on the grace to be brought to you when Jesus Christ is revealed at his coming.
Yes.
As obedient children, do not conform to the evil desires you had when you lived in ignorance.
Uh-huh.
But just as he who called you is holy, so be holy in all you do.
Uh-huh.
For it is written, be holy because I am holy.
Yes.
May God have a blessing upon the word.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
And truly we know today is our Youth Sunday. And we thank God that the bishop is allowing the youth to exercise their talents in the service of today.
Yes.
So let's give our youth worship leaders a hand clap.
Yes.
And then bring forth our worship and praise on this Sunday.
Thank you.
asked the children to go to the book of Acts and find a miracle.
Yes.
They're gonna come up here, tell us their miracle, and we'll write it down. So I believe the youngest one in the house right now is Damae. So let's give him a hand as he comes.
Come on, Damae.
Saul was blinded. Saul was blinded and healed.
Miracle I show is the latent voice of Saul's conversion.
Version. It can be found in Acts chapter 9, verses 1 through 9.
Amen, amen, amen. Thank you, Taylor, for that miracle. And our last miracle will be coming from Chavez. Let's give him a hand.
The miracle I chose is a lame man was healed. And this is in Acts 3, verse 1 through 10. In the book of Acts.
so much in the book of Acts.
Yes, there is.
Some people call it the Acts of the Apostles.
Hallelujah.
And then others call it the Acts of the Holy Ghost.
All right, now.
Whatever you choose to call it, the apostles were used by God through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ by the anointing of the Holy Ghost.
Amen. Amen.
To establish the church. The book of Acts is the establishment. The establishment of God's church. The Church of Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Here on earth. Is that all right?
Amen.
Amen. And we thank God. We thank God for our great church.
Amen.
One church.
Yes.
Right.
One church. The Church of Jesus Christ.
Yes.
There may be many denominations, but there is only one church.
Church.
Amen.
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 Sister Johnson Reed, let's go into the Word of God. Please read.
Acts 10, 44 through 46, King James Version. While Peter yet spake these words, the Holy Ghost fell on all them which heard the word. And they of the circumcision which were believed were astonished, as many as came with Peter, because that on the Gentiles also was poured out the gift of the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
For they heard them speak with tongues and magnify God. Then answered Peter. Acts 11, 15 through 18, King James Version. And as I speak, as I begin to speak, the Holy Ghost fell on them, and on us at the beginning. Then remembered I the word of the Lord, how that he said, John indeed baptized with water, but ye shall be baptized with the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
For as much then as God gave them the like gift, as he did unto us, who believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, what was I that I could withstand God? When they heard these things, they held their peace.
Yes.
And glorified God, saying, then hath God also to the Gentiles granted repentance unto life.
Thank you, Sister Johnson.
Hallelujah.
For the reading of God's word.
Amen.
And I want to talk from the subject today.
There is
only one Holy Ghost.
Ooh, Lord.
Amen.
And I want to ask a question. Is he living in you?
Lord have mercy.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Yes, he is.
Yes, yes.
There is only one Holy Ghost.
One.
Is he living in you?
Amen.
Oh, yes, Lord. Yes.
Somebody can shout back, yes!
Yes!
He lives in me.
He lives in me.
Hallelujah.
And you got to know that you have him.
The
Spirit of the living God.
Lord,
yes, Lord.
Through Jesus Christ living in you.
Right.
Now I'm always amazed when it seems as though when you hear different people talk And they say, the Holy Ghost told me this. And they say what the Holy Ghost told them. And then you can go to somebody else's video on the internet. Talking about stuff you see. And someone else will say, the Holy Ghost spoke to me and told me this. And they are the complete opposite. They contradict each other. And you begin to wonder, do they think there's more than one?
Right. Come on now.
That's why you got to be careful who you allow to tell you that the Holy Ghost spoke to them about you.
Right.
You
reach it now.
Right.
That's why I asked the question, is he living in you?
Right.
Because if he's living in you, why would he need somebody else to tell somebody else about you?
Right. Yeah.
That's so true.
When he could have done it himself.
That's right.
Now you're right, Bishop.
There you go.
Yeah.
One thing I understand is that it is possible. Based upon your condition, your health condition, that he could speak to you.
Yes.
Amen.
And tell you not to take something.
Amen.
Amen.
Because he knows it will harm you.
Right. Amen. Yeah.
Amen.
That was for you.
For you. That's right, Bishop.
Amen.
That's for you.
But what you do, you get on the internet, on television, on the radio, and claim that he told you that for everybody. But someone else will say, no.
Amen.
He told me it was okay. For me to take this medicine. This is why the world is so confused. About the church.
Yes.
And I'm not talking about the Church of Jesus Christ. I'm talking about denominations.
Right.
One denomination said they're moving by the power, by the Spirit of God. And they'll do something totally different than another denomination. He may move. He being the Holy Ghost may move in different ways. In different services. Some clap fast. Some clap slow. Some dance. Some won't. Some lift their hands and worship throughout the whole service. Some don't.
Amen.
The problem is when you feel as though if you don't do it like me, then you don't have the Holy Ghost. But let me tell you, no one denomination has a monopoly on the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Come on now.
Just like no one denomination has no denomination has a monopoly on God.
Right.
Or his son Jesus.
That's right.
That's why it is important to know him for yourself.
Amen. Hallelujah. That's right. Got to know him.
That's why it's important for you to have a leader and a pastor.
Right.
You need to stop strangers from pulling you out.
Right.
Amen. And telling you what the Holy Ghost said.
Right.
When they know nothing about your life. And what they tell you is totally in contrary to what your leader said.
Right. Yeah, that's true.
who know all about you.
Know all about you.
You're slothful.
Come on. No.
Hateful. Rebellious.
Yeah.
Come on.
Disobedient.
Yeah.
And they did all they can to work with you.
Yes.
All they can.
To get you right in the sight of God.
Right. Amen.
Yes.
And you'll go somewhere.
You're
speaking.
And somebody who say they have the Holy Ghost will tell you you're okay.
Right.
And you'll go along with it.
You
know why?
Because
you don't have it.
Right.
Amen.
Right.
Amen. That's right, Bishop.
Yeah.
And they're saying what you want to hear.
That's what you want to hear. Telling you your wrong is right.
You've got to make sure that you understand that Jesus died for everyone.
Yes,
Amen.
He did.
Yes, he did now.
Amen.
And said, whosoever will, let them come. He died for you.
Amen.
But you got to respond.
Right.
To his death and resurrection.
Right.
In other words, you got to accept it.
Right.
You.
Somebody shout, free will.
Free will.
Means free choice.
Means free choice.
But when we understand that Jesus told his disciples to stay in Jerusalem,
Lord, never,
until you be endowed,
right here,
with power from on high.
Yes.
Right.
Power to be a witness. We should be doing.
Yes.
Witnessing. Not every time you get up, you got a prophecy.
Right.
Woo.
Lord,
amen.
I never seen the time now you turn on YouTube, TikTok, Facebook. There's so many people out there with what the Holy Ghost said.
Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
And you looking at them saying, look, I don't want to say you didn't. He didn't say that.
Right.
But what you're saying don't make sense.
No, it
don't
make sense.
Amen. Amen.
Then you laugh at folks and get angry at folks that speak intelligently.
Right.
That's right.
Yeah. My Holy Ghost is intelligent.
Yeah, mine too.
Amen.
It don't have me saying silly stuff.
No.
Through the airwaves. You looking at me, my Holy Ghost telling me to tell you, you're going to get a car, but you got to send me a cash app of
$100.
Make no sense.
If we see or not,
because
this pandemic has brought it out.
Yeah,
it has, Bishop.
A lot of these preachers love the virtual church. Why? Because they can stand there and tell you, according to them, what the Lord is saying.
Amen.
And they know nothing about you.
Right.
Not one thing.
Amen. Nothing.
You need a pastor.
Yes.
You need a leader.
Yes.
That's going to teach you what thus says the Lord.
Yes.
So that you receive the Holy Ghost,
Amen.
The power of the living God,
yes.
To help you live holy,
yes.
To help you live right, in these last and evil days.
Yes.
Can I get a witness?
Yes.
Amen.
We need it.
In our lesson today, we got to be careful that we don't allow ourselves to think that we're the only church that is right.
Right.
Our organization is the only organization that is right. It makes me sick to hear people stand up and call you part of an organization. We the greatest church in the world. My presiding bishop is the greatest leader in the world. My pastor is the greatest pastor in the world. happen to you.
Right.
Because it's all you know.
That's all you know, Bishop.
All you know. All you know. Amen.
Or that you so love. So you don't compare people with somebody else.
Right.
And just say, my pastor is one of the greatest pastors.
Right.
Because there are many great pastors.
Yes.
Yes, there are.
My bishop is one of the greatest bishops.
Yes, right.
Because there are many great bishops.
Yes, there are.
You're right.
My chief apostle is one of the great chief apostles.
Right.
Because there are many.
Yeah.
Yes, there are.
It sounds to me you are praising man more than you're praising God.
Yes.
Right.
That's what they do.
Then when they drop off and die, you don't know what to do.
What to do?
Had they taught you to follow Jesus,
right,
who said, I am he, that was dead.
Yeah.
But I'm alive forevermore.
That's right.
Somebody shout, Jesus is alive forevermore.
Jesus is alive forevermore.
And if you're going to get this one Holy Ghost, this one and only Holy Ghost, you got to get it through Jesus Christ.
Jesus Christ.
That's the only way.
In our lesson today, I'm going to back it up and start first with the 11th chapter in Acts. And then I'll go to the 10th chapter. Because in the 11th chapter of Acts, something happens. Because it's after Peter's encounter with Cornelius and others. And now he goes back to Judea. Goes back to Jerusalem. And he's confronted by the Jews.
Oh,
you know, some of them had some bad attitudes.
Terrible.
Amen.
I'm not talking about the Pharisees.
Right.
I'm talking about the one that said they know Jesus.
Right.
Right.
The people. Right. You're right.
They really thought the Holy Ghost was only for them.
Right.
They confronted Peter, the Bible says. And they said to him, when he came into Jerusalem, I'm just paraphrasing.
Right.
Because they heard about what happened. And they confront him.
Lord have mercy.
And they were angry.
Lord have mercy.
And they said to him, wait a minute. We heard that you went to the uncircumcised.
Lord have mercy.
Amen.
You went to non-Jewish people?
Lord have mercy.
You went to the Gentiles? And not only that, you sat down and ate with them?
Yeah.
This is the problem. This is the problem
with
us church people. Because we have become so standoffish. So judgmental.
Come on now.
The people look at us
and
wonder, do we really have the Spirit of God? They wrote these people off. They wrote them off. And just to paraphrase, you can read it in the 11th chapter. Peter's like, wait a minute, y'all. Peter says, I was in the city of Joppa.
Praying.
And Peter goes on to explain just what happened, what God did for him. How God put him in a trance to see a vision. how God let down what Peter described as a large sheet. Animals.
That's right.
And the Lord said, kill and eat. And Peter said, no, Lord, come. That was their law. The Lord said, clean. Don't you call him. Peter said, look, I am following what God told me to do. Somebody shout, what God told me to do.
What God told me to do.
And Peter said, this was done three times. Three times this was done.
Right.
I got it. You think I'm going to argue and fight against God?
No.
And Peter, you can read this. Peter began to tell them what happened. And when Peter told them what happened, and we'll talk about that in a few moments. Peter told them the Holy Ghost fell on them. These Gentiles, who you all are mad that I spoke to, that I met with, said the same Holy Ghost that fell on us fell on them.
Yeah.
Amen. Same.
And Peter said, I remembered the word of Jesus Christ, my Lord.
Lord.
Yes.
When he said, John indeed baptized with water, but ye shall be baptized, somebody shout, with the Holy Ghost.
With the Holy Ghost.
Peter said, it was God who gave them the same Holy Ghost.
Same Holy Ghost.
That he did to us.
Amen.
When they believe in the Lord Jesus Christ. Do you think I'm going to fight against God? For you?
No.
And when Peter said that, he shut their mouths. The Bible said they had to hold their peace. One thing about the Holy Ghost, I'm talking about the one and true Holy Ghost. When he starts working,
right.
You got to back down.
Back down.
You dealing with the power of God. They held their peace, the Bible said, and they began to glorify God, saying God also has given the Gentiles, he granted them repentance unto life.
Amen.
Well, what happened? What happened? Well, the Bible says, and I'll read a little bit here and there, jump around, because I don't want to be too long.
Boy.
Tell it.
You know, we don't like long sermons.
Tell it.
The older I get, I don't like long sermons. I'm finding as I get older, I'm trying to cut it short, y'all. You know why? Because I'll be honest with you. Sometimes I look at some of those sermons on the internet, and I see 2 hours, I said, I can't go there. Because a lot of time, all they're doing is yelling and screaming.
That's right.
But I'm finding, again, there's different cultures.
That's right.
You know what I said? In some churches, you don't have to yell and scream.
Right.
You can stand there and teach.
That's right.
And folks will sit right there for hours.
Wow. Right there.
But then there's some churches. You better yell. You better scream.
Right.
Because you're going to look up and everybody's going to be sleeping.
Right.
Right.
Amen. Amen.
Huh? Y'all know the joke I told years ago?
Yes, Lord. Amen.
Pastor was preaching. one of the deacons, hey, go wake him up. The deacon told him, you wake him up. You put him to sleep. You know also what I told you. People just yelling, yes, Lord, Lord, in the name of Jesus, have your way, God. Say nothing. Come on, Jesus. Eagle,
yeah.
Just yelling and yelling and yelling and yelling. And you know the person told the joke? So after a while, even God spoke from heaven and said, will you shut up? Sometimes you want to say to a lot of preachers, shut up.
Right.
But you're not saying anything to help anybody.
Right.
So I don't want to be long. Put y'all to sleep. I have to hear a voice from heaven saying, will you shut up? The Bible says very quickly, and I'll read a little bit from the easy to read version of the Bible. The 10th chapter of the book of Acts. Very quickly, it says, in the city of Caesarea, there was a man named Cornelius, a Roman army officer, in what was called the Italian unit. He was a religious man. He and all the others who lived in this house, they were worshipers of the true God. Here's this Gentile. He was a worshiper of the true God. The Bible says he gave much of his money to help the poor people and always prayed to God. Then the Bible said one afternoon about 3 o'clock, Cornelius had a vision. He clearly saw an angel from God coming to him and saying, Cornelius. Staring at the angel and feeling afraid, Cornelius said, what do you want, sir? The angel said to him, God has heard your prayers and has seen your gifts to the poor, and he remembers you and all you have done. How many know God is watching us?
Yeah.
Somebody said, I'm so glad God is watching me.
I'm so glad.
And when it seems that nobody wants to recognize the good you do, just keep on doing it.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Because God will reward your faithfulness.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
The angel says, send some men to the city of Joppa to get a man named Simon, who is also called Peter. He's staying with another man, Simon, a leather worker. And Cornelius obeyed. Now, I'm not going to read the whole thing. As I said before, I'm just going to paraphrase it in my own way. The men went to Joppa. And they found Peter. Mind you, I already told you, Peter already had a vision. The Bible talks about in that ninth verse, the next day, after the angel appeared to Cornelius, Peter had a vision about, as I said a moment ago, the animals. God was getting him ready. How many know God knows how to do things?
Yes, he does.
And he said, Peter, I got to get your attention.
Because
you're part of that group too.
Because
they were looking for Jesus to put them back still on top.
Amen.
So Peter has a vision that I spoke about a moment ago. I said about unclean animals, so on and so forth. And he understood, I got to obey God. But I really don't know what this vision means.
Right.
Huh? the men who Cornelius sent to find Peter, they found Peter. They found Peter.
Amen.
And they told Peter why they were there. And Peter asked the men to stay the night. The next day, Peter and some of the believers from Joppa went with these men. They came to Caesarea, and Cornelius was waiting for them. Somebody shout, he was waiting for them.
He was waiting for them.
Wait.
And when he got there, the Bible says, Peter went into the house, met Cornelius, and Cornelius fell at Peter's feet and began to worship him. And Peter, I like this. He told him, get up.
Get up.
Stand up. I am only a man like you. Well, a lot of bishops need to read this.
All right. Yep.
Man.
A lot of overseers. You need to read this.
All right.
Right.
A lot of apostles, you need to read this.
Yeah,
you need to read it now.
Pastors, you need to read this. Anybody that want people to worship them, my pastor does, my pastor does, my bishop does, my overseer does, my apostle does. You talk more about them than you do Jesus.
All right.
Peter said, no. You're not going to do this.
Right.
I'm a man like you're a man.
Uh-huh.
I'm a human just like you're a human.
Yeah.
I breathe like you breathe.
Uh-huh.
I bleed like you bleed.
Uh-huh.
One of these days I'm going to die like you're going to die.
Yes.
But there is a man by the name of Jesus. Somebody shout, he deserves all the glory.
Yeah.
Because at the end of the day, I don't care what your title is. You are only a servant.
Yeah.
Can I get a witness? I don't care if you're a chief apostle of some large organization. That don't mean anything. I don't care if you got millions of people following you. Are you humble?
Amen. Hallelujah.
That's what God is looking for. When I look at people on television, I'm looking for a humble spirit.
Right.
I say, God, I hope people can see that Bishop Green is John Green.
Right.
And I'm humble.
Yes.
I'm going to stay humble.
Yes.
Right.
I ain't trying to be above nobody.
No.
Because nobody's above me.
Right.
Because somebody shall be all the same.
We're all the same.
Servants of the Most High God. Jesus Christ.
Yes. Amen.
And you ought to be glad for your place. Somebody shall stay in your place.
Stay in your place.
You stay in your place, God can use you.
Yeah.
When the judges say stay in your lane.
Yeah.
She said.
Huh?
Stay.
You'd be amazed now how the church done lost their place and lost their lane.
All right.
And that's why there is so much collision.
Yes.
So much trouble. So much fighting.
Yes.
So much confusion.
Yes.
Why? Why? Because everybody want a name. But somebody want to take the lead like Peter. Peter told Cornelius, get up. No, I don't deserve to be worshipped.
Right.
I didn't die for you.
No.
I don't deserve to be worshipped.
Amen.
deserve to be worshipped.
Right.
I came here because the Holy Ghost led me here.
Right.
Right, the Holy Ghost. And the power of God led me here.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
And the Bible says, Peter continued talking with Cornelius.
Hallelujah.
Peter went inside
and
saw a large group of people gathered there.
Yes.
And Peter didn't preach about himself.
No.
I'm finished.
Come on.
He didn't preach about the Jewish faith.
All
right.
Come on.
He didn't preach about tithes and offerings.
No.
All right.
He didn't preach. About diamond and furs.
Right.
All right.
The people was there waiting to hear.
Right.
Somebody shout a word from the Lord.
A word from the Lord.
This is what I want to hear when I go to church.
Yeah.
Somebody shout, I want a word from the Lord.
I want a word from the Lord.
I don't want a word that's just going to entertain me for a couple moments.
Right.
And this is what's happening now. We search the internet to find messages that's going to entertain us for the moment. Because when the moment is over, you don't got your entertainment, and you can't remember nothing you heard.
Nothing.
Why? Because what you heard was nothing.
Right, right.
Can I get away with
it?
But these people, along with Cornelius, they sat there ready and eager to hear a word. That's when I get up on Sunday morning, you ought to say, I'm getting up. And going to God's house. And I'm going there to give him praise. I'm going there to worship him.
Yeah.
I'm going there to glorify him.
Yeah.
I'm going there to magnify him.
Yeah.
But most important, I'm going to get a word. Somebody shout a word. They're not giving us a word of Jesus.
Right.
A word about Jesus. Somebody shout, Jesus.
Jesus.
When Peter got there, Peter started expounding on the life, the teaching, the living, the death, resurrection of Jesus Christ. Can I get away with this?
Man,
he started.
Somebody
shout, all power. Now some of the power. Telling him,